Good morning. Wake up. It's Monday. I don't know where you are, but for Bethany and I, it's 10.
Right? It is 10.
It is Monday, I think. Is it Monday?
It is. It's Monday. We should have.
I'm hooked on a rug. Caught where we're things that we're doing and not doing, we are is stopping us from where we want to be in life and the meaning that we want to have, because we really do want to have meaning. And then we are in a constant self-attack cycle around what we're doing and not doing. Mm-hmm. And so we just kind of can't win. And I see that pain. I think we see it more clearly inside of people because we know what's going on, even though they're like, what? No, I'm fine. I just can't get out of my own way. So of course I hate myself for that. Right.
You know, I just got a text, you know, just to, you know, give an example. I just got a text from a friend yesterday. It was on Facebook or whatever. My daughter had her dress rehearsal on Friday for her dance program, right? I have a little picture around here. I'll show you guys her, right? She loves dance. She's amazing, right? So whatever, it was at the studio. It wasn't on stage. She's only four. And so, you know, I was just showing pictures of it. And my friend who, you know, super achiever, you know, is on a couple of different boards, you know, works, has her own practice as a therapist, but also supports her husband who's a periodontist, you know, all this stuff. Has her own kid, took on his couple kids, you know, there's a lot going on. Mm-hmm. She texts me, right? And she's like, ooh, this is a mom fail. She's like, totally forgot about that dress rehearsal. And I just think, mom fail, you know, and that's, and I don't know what's going on. Yet. We didn't really chit chat about it, but that is like a prime example of somebody just giving, and that's pretty much all of us. And that's what Margaret's talking about, where it's like, not like, oh, it's like mom fail. How is that a fail? Like, oh my God, like everything you have going on. And then how long does that stay inside? How long does that, how long does that circulate? How are we talking about it? How are we just like, God, I can't believe I did that. And instead of just being like, oh geez, you know what? Life happens and oops. And by the way, he's five. It wasn't like he was, you know, missed his major audition, you know, for his future career.
Yeah, but you're right. Like any mistake isn't a mistake. It's a fail. And there's never any context, you know? And I think what happens is when we eventually blow up and say to our partners or somebody like, oh my God, I'm doing this and this and this and this and this, and I'm so overwhelmed and I missed this. That is usually something that we also regret, like, because it built up and we broke down or blew up, and that also doesn't solve the problem. And then we leave that experience going, well, like, that was horrible. I totally embarrassed myself, right? So when we look back on times when we finally lost it after all the pressure, we say, I embarrassed myself. Mm-hmm. You know, I looked weak, or I humiliated myself, or I was a jerk, or whatever.
Yeah, why am I such a jerk?
Yeah, I publicly embarrassed myself, right? Because I lost it. And so we just put we're constantly in these, there's no win situation where I can't win. And that does drive me. I know it drives you. We are people that we see, that we work with, that are kind and loving and smart and accomplished and amazing and actually care. And they don't deserve to suffer that way. And the other thing that drives me, so that's the pain, is what's on the other side.
I know.
You know, is you and I get to see on a regular basis people who've done everything, tried everything, every therapy, every program, and they step into the real work and they become alive. They become joyful. They become present. They become on fire. They become funny.
Yeah.
Right? They become happy and joyful and kick ass. Yeah. And that is such a indescribable experience to be part of, right? To be part of. Not for the glory of Bethany and Margaret, but for the glory of them, right?
And them. And the people they touch and the lives they touch. So I always like to add that little piece of it, because it's such, there's so many examples. And I was going to say, Margaret, we both have really good examples of this, even in our own current lives, but our clients, the same thing. It's like, you know, and we want to focus on you because you're the one, you know, that we want to, you know, have you exploding and feeling that, you know, that beauty and all that. But at the same time, when you do this work, it does 100% affect the people around you and lift all everybody up, including your family members, including your friends, and the people that are closest to you. And that's, you know, it's like the gift that keeps on giving. Yes.
And so if you're listening and you're a realtor or a financial advisor or a, you know, yoga teacher, it's like when you transform, the effect that you will have on your family and those around you in that ripple effect. And then we have the special, what did I call them on the video? I think I mean on the webinar, like the 10 percenters or something.
Yeah.
We have that group of people that follow me that want to do the same thing, that want to not just be the ripple effect in by their own joyful being, but actually want to actively transform other people and bring them into their power, bring them out of pain, whether it's pain just of not living your life purpose, which is painful enough.
Yes, it is. From,
you know, out of trauma, out of emotional pain, out of actual physical pain. And that's who I was speaking to on the webinar. So that's really cool for me because now you and I are talking to ourselves, right? Yeah. Those of you out there who are Bethany and me, who want to support and help other people, and the invitation to actually learn from me is out there. So, so we announced on the webinar that June 17th on Monday is day one, chakra one day for me to teach you exactly what I do on the lower four chakras, and it's virtual, right? So it'll be just like this kind of.
So cool.
Everybody will be sitting in their spaces. Going like, oh, my rug's hooked on my chair. And people's cats and dogs jump into the frame. I don't have any bunnies I can show you.
No, but I know my dog's like MIA. But you know what's really cool about this experience is that, you know, you've got these sort of 4 days, you know, these four deep dive days, right? And what's really amazing is it's like an accelerator, right? It's like an accelerator. Yeah. So it's a deep immersion, whether you are like Margaret and myself and you really want to do this work and you're like, yes, I want to learn it, I want to teach it, and it's so powerful and amazing and transform everybody. Or you're like just sitting there, you're like, you know what, I want this accelerator. I want to, you know, take this massive amount of like 4 days of compressed sort of transformation and like skyrocket to something, right? So you've got this, you're up leveling, you're moving through something, you want to move through something. It's a perfect opportunity in this contained space to really like ignite that and light that fire and start to really blast through some major stuff in such a short period of time.
And we've had people say, I don't think I have any plans to coach or use this with other people, but I need this chakra work is doing something to me and I need it. We've had some people who were like lifetime, way longer than me, career tapping professionals come. Yes. So that they can get the transformation that they need. Like chakra work goes into your blind spot. So you can be tapping for 25 years and not actually find your own blind spot. And then incorporate everything that I've taught them and certified them to do into their own work to make it powerful. Right. We had therapists come and say, I just want the transformation. And then they're like, maybe I could take on a client on the side for this. Or I can help my I can help my nephew with some of this, right? Mm-hmm. That I can't really do with talk therapy because that's a whole relationship thing, right? I could show my nephew this tapping now, right? Yeah. So it is a pretty amazing event. I would say effing amazing.
Effing amazing, and you know whether you're winding
A full transformation over four chakras, and you're doing 12 individual complete guided processes and tapping. So it's just like, blah.
It's a blast.
Week, right? So it's Monday, June 17th, everybody, in your yoga pants, in a t-shirt, on your webcam, from home. No travel. Knock off this $2,000 probably saved for most people in travel.
Plus endless snacks and beverages, which is what I was like.
Your own snacks and beverages. You don't have to pay for coffee.
Endless.
And so the travel, because it is a full week, you don't, you know, staying in a hotel and everything, we're probably talking about $2,000 savings on the travel. And of course you can be, you know, on the other side of the earth and it doesn't really matter. So it's Monday, June 17th, Tuesday and Wednesday. So that's chakra 1, 2, and 3. Then we take one day of a break, which is Thursday. And then Friday is chakra 4 day, which is probably the most intense day. Although it builds on the other 3 days. And in each day you learn, you first experience and then learn and then practice on another person. And you know, what we're doing right now is so cool because this is what happens when we practice, right? So you'll have everybody on camera, all these people on camera, and then we press a button, boink, and all of a sudden it looks like this. It's you and one other person. Right? And it works.
It's amazing. It's magic. So amazing. It is.
Yeah, you're all of a sudden in a room, a virtual room with one other person, and you're now practicing on each other. Oh, I just lost Bethaney. It's a reverse miracle. She'll be back. Let me text her so she knows she's gone. but it works. And so you actually get to have the experience and lost you, have the experience, and then learn about it, right? Because now you're with a bunch of other people who've had the same experience. And of course, you've got the whole manual. And you're hearing their reactions, which is a way to prepare you to hear from, you two. I'm on. Hold on. I am on. it's a way to prepare you to practice on clients, because you're hearing like a ton of other people's reaction to the process that you just experienced and learned. And then you take your manual, which has the entire scripting and the tapping scripting, not just the tapping, but everything you say to your client to set it up, to walk them through, and then the tapping. And boink, you end up in a room with one other person. We don't use this technology, so it's actually more stable. And then you practice on each other, right? So you each get 20 minutes of practicing on each other. So now you've experienced everything first. Let me see if she can get back on. Mm-hmm. Okay, she can't get back on, but we're actually wrapping up anyway. So that's what's happening on June 17th. If you haven't seen the webinar, we are going to replay it for just a couple of days so you actually can get the replay. Just send an email to support@margaretmlynch.com. And we will give you the replay because I really taught in a different way than I ever have before. I'm getting better at explaining it, how the first chakra works as your foundation of power, that stand your ground energy, how the second chakra works as your fuel to actually compel you into action with your desire for what you want, or your rising desire for what you don't want at all. And that rising feeling comes into your third chakra, where everything becomes real and visible because you take action, not just the same kind of action, doing, but action on your desires. Again, your desire for what you want and your desire for what you realize, I don't want that, I don't like that. Those are both desires rising, and that's the fuel for the third chakra. And then at the fourth chakra has a very special function in this empowerment channel. As we go from first to second to third in the empowerment energy, you take action, empowered action at the third chakra. And then the fourth chakra's job as your most powerful chakra, filled with compassion and patience and wisdom and seeing the big picture, and wisdom, I can't say that enough, is that it watches you every time in your life that you've taken empowered action, that you've taken action on what you want or what you don't want, which means pushing back, saying no, asking for more, whatever it is. The heart cheers you on and encourages you even with the mistakes you make when you step out. So the heart chakra looks at you, watches you, sees you, and inside of you is saying to you, oh my God, I'm doing this. I'm so proud of myself. And what happens instead is that the first chakra, instead of it being your foundation of power, it will be this shaky foundation that doesn't feel safe, that there is going to be some kind of punishment or pushback. So I need to hide, or I need to be in battle all the time, or I need to be anxious all the time, or I need to just follow the rules. At the second chakra, when we feel that desire rising up, whether it's what we don't want, we'll say it's not appropriate for me. I don't want to be angry and rock the boat. Or we feel our desire coming up for what we do want, we'll say, I'm not comfortable having needs. And so we will defeat that empowerment energy. And then when we get to the third chakra, all we can do is try to be visible in a way that doesn't break any rules and fits in. Oh, she might be back. She's coming back. I'm like, we have to wrap up. I'm already over. I'm just walking through the chakras.
Oh, wow.
So at the third chakra, all we have left is to be visible in a way that keeps us safe and by accommodating and not breaking rules. And then at the heart chakra, what happens is instead of using its beautiful wisdom, it uses its false wisdom and it scrutinizes you. And every time you do something empowered or act on your own needs, it will look at you and go, that was a disaster. You embarrassed and humiliated yourself. Look at all of the mistakes you made, instead of encouraging you. And so this is how we work through each one of these chakras. Three unique step-by-step processes to clear away the trauma, to open the energy, to unblock the chakra, unblock the energy, and that unblocks your life. Three times unblocking. Ooh, three ways to unblock. And we do that in every chakra. Yeah. And it's actually a certification program for those who want to be totally certified at the end because of all the practice time, you get certified. So I can't wait. Bethaney and I will be there together virtually.
We will. We shall.
Ooh, wait, looks like we're leaning in. Virtual. Yeah, we're hugging. All right, guys, make sure you check out the replay. If you haven't seen that and it's, what I'm talking about is interesting to you, there's no other light work like this on the planet. People might talk about the chakras, but they're not teaching you how to do what I do as expertly as we do it after a decade and teach you that so you can use it with your own family or clients or patients. This is the only place you can get it. And it's coming up in a couple of weeks. Yeah. All right, guys. We'll see you soon. Thanks for coming back, B.
Thanks.
I appreciate you.
I appreciate you, sister.
Bye.
Bye.